So you performed You're the One That I Want for us, which obviously made famous by John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John in Grease. Why that song?
I guess I chose the song. I didn't actually choose the song. I think for me it's just a little bit of old musicals always come into my head when I'm playing the guitar without thinking about anything. So sometimes I'm singing lyrics of my own, and then other times like The Little Mermaid slips in, or Calamity Jane, or you know, something from when I was growing up. Yeah. And one time I started singing these words, and because I know Grease back to front, you know, it's
who doesn't?
Yeah,
we've got a room of people that will all start singing Grease songs.
They should do one of those things, you know. You can go and see The Sound of Music and watch it, and everybody
and join
sings.
In.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Maybe. Have they not done that for Grease yet?
They probably have. I just haven't been told about it.
You gave it kind of like a whole different meaning. Mm-hmm. Because obviously it's like this big, happy love song, isn't it?
Yeah.
But it almost came across as a little bit, not sinister, that's the wrong word, but kind of something kind of, I don't know.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. Yeah. I mean, when she's singing it at the end of the film, it's like there's so much hope in it, because she's realised, even though she's singing it and she's being playful with him, she knows it's going to work out. You know, he's mesmerised by her. Mm-hmm. When I sing it, I feel like the way that I'm seeing it or thinking about it is, I'm kind of disappointed. You know, I feel like I've met somebody, they're amazing. They're exactly what I want, but they can't get it together, you know? And it's a little bit like that, like, come on, you're perfect and this could be amazing and you just haven't quite got it, you know? And I think that sort of makes it a little bit, maybe not so fun.
Well, I think it sounded absolutely brilliant. It really did. Let's talk a little bit about your new album, It By The Horn.
Yeah.
Because you worked with some incredible people on it. Tell us about them.
Well, I mean, Thomas was the person that I mostly wanted to work with for a couple of years because of his music. He creates beautiful records with his solo project called Dove Man, and I became a big fan of his a couple of years ago. And I just listened to his records a lot, The Conformist and With My Left Hand I Raise the Dead. They were always in my head, especially flying, you know. I guess when I'm on planes I get more emotional than ever, and I listen to his music and I was like,
why did you get more emotional on planes, just out of curiosity?
I don't know. I think I've thought about this a lot because I cry a lot, but I mostly cry when I'm on an aeroplane watching a bad movie.
Really?
Yeah.
Why is that? Is it because the movie's bad? Is it the idea that if this plane goes down, this is my last memory of life? Is
I think it's that the feeling of change is really apparent when you're in the air. It's like you don't belong anywhere. You're going between places and you're leaving people behind. And maybe you're excited as well because you're seeing new people. But there's this sense that everything is in motion and you're right in the middle of that feeling.
Yeah.
And I don't know, it makes, I think also just physically as well, you're a little bit not in your body because it's a strange sensation to be up in the sky in a weird tin can floating.
It's horrible.
It's,
I always have to be on Valium, so I'm never in my own head. I don't know what's going on when I'm on a plane.
That's actually, it's a good idea if you can handle Valium.
Yeah. Well,
last time I did it, I was like, poking the chicken and stuff, and it was not cool.
As in the food,
they brought it out, and I was
you didn't take a chicken on a plane.
It was a real chicken. It was a dead chicken. It was the meal, and they put it down, and I was like, my friend told me afterwards. Actually, she was here. She was watching me, and she goes, "Do you remember what you were doing with the chicken?" And this is the first time I'd taken drugs on a plane. It was not a good scene. Confession that most people don't know about. Maybe my sister and brother might remember from when I was a kid, but I used to really love the smell of cat food, and I used to sneak into the pantry and just smell it, you know, and I was so in love with this smell of the cat food. It was the dry cat food, not the wet cat food, just to get that clear. So one time I snuck out to the shed when I was up at Granny and Grandpa's farm, and I ate some of the dry cat food. And it tasted really bad. And that was it. The love affair finished. So but nobody knows that I eat cat food.
Can't you see? Oh, no.